Okay, good evening. Last day, what we have discussed is about bitwise operators. We have discussed bitwise O operator, bitwise N operator, and bitwise NOT operator. I said that the bitwise NOT operator is basically, you can understand it easily by understanding 2's complement numbers. Okay, if you can remember the results of these bitwise operators, so here, please see the example. If both are given in binary, it's very easy to find out because O will, this is similar to O gate. What it does, it will basically, O gate result is, you know, one of these is one of corresponding bits. One of these corresponding bits is one. O, if both are one, it is one. If both are zero, corresponding bit zero, then zero. Then here, zero, one, actually one bit is one, it's one. Zero, one, again one bit is one, one. One, zero, again one bit is, this bit is one. So therefore one, one, zero, again, this is one. And one, 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 and that will be converted back to the, back to normal decimal numbers. That is how the bitwise operators work. 9 and 23, 9 means 1001. You can put zero, the like leading zero is okay because that will not change the value. So you can put lead in zero. In front, you can use a zero. And here 23 is 10111. That is the binary value. We know how to convert that because we have learned that in the binary lesson. So in case if you were not there in the binary lesson, how can we convert 23? If it is there, what you need to do is divide by 2 and write the remainder. It is 1, 1 and remaining 1. And then divide by 2 again. This is 5 and remaining 1. And divide by 2 again. So it is 2 and remaining 1 and divide by 2 again, then it is 1 and remaining 0. So the number will be read from bottom to top. It is 10111. So this number. And how can we convert 9 into binary? Just divide by 2, similar to this. And it is 4 remaining 1 and divide by 2 again. That is 2 remaining 0. And divide by 2 again, so that is 1 and remaining 0. So that will be read from bottom to top. It is 1001. So this is how the numbers are generated in binary. And then merging of this, actually, let me show the truth table of for O gate. If you can remember, truth table, this is A and B. So let's consider 2 bits and the output is A or B. And how it is done? 0, 0, if both are 0, then the output is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, the output is 0, 0, 1, the output is 1, and 1, 0, the output is again 1, and 1, oh, 1 is output again 1. So this is how OR gate is work. For 2 inputs, for 3 inputs also it is same. If all are 0, only 0. If all inputs 0, then 0. Otherwise, that's easy way to remember. AND gate, how it works? AND gate works the opposite way. Actually, if A, B are there, and A and B is written like this, in both A, B, 0, it's obviously 0. So similar to O gate, but 0, 1 is also 0. The reason is, both need to be 1 in order to get 1 from AND gate. And 1, 0 is also 0 because both need to be 1 in order to get AND gate 1. And if both are 1, then only it will output. So this is so similar in this is similar in 3 inputs. In 3 inputs also, if there are 3 inputs, all A, B, C are 1, then only this one. This is AND gate. So this AND gate and OR gate is applicable here. So this AND gate and OR gate applicable here. So that is what we are using. O gate and gate. A, O, B, A and B. Right. So let's do a small question again to understand this O logic and logic. And this time I need to do this operation. Please let me know the output of this. I'm telling, okay, 17 or 17 or 9 and 9 and 42. Can you tell me the output? 1709 and 42. Now two both operations are there. O operation is also there. And operation is also there. I just need your output. So please send the answer to the to this chat. Please send the answer to the chat. Don't do this in Python, then you will get the answer easily. But don't do it without doing this. Try to figure out, because this is practicing, right? In practicing, you don't want to find the exact answer. In practicing, what you need to do is you need to find out whether you are capable of discovering the answer, whether you know the method or not. That is what the practicing session is. So don't worry. Don't try to generate the answer. That is not required here. Only try to figure out the answer. If your method is correct, then that's it. Okay, do it quickly. You can do this within 1 minute. Alhara, 25. Others, no answers. 17, you need to convert. 17, you need to convert that to binary. 17 convert gram n. Once 17 is converted, you can see 1001, right? This is 17. Then 9 is anyway 1001. Mulata 0 ekak danna. This is O gate, and for the AND gate 42. 42 kiyanne tika liyanna one 36 ne 32 ni 32 ekka 32 ek 16 naha meka 42
8 and 2
check whether this is correct etakota metana tiyenawa 10ak 10 ay ekathu karanna ona 32 ne 8 ay 32 32 10 32 so what will happen first so typically when there are two operations AND will happen first when there are two operations AND is the first thing to happen. Therefore, AND gate will be here. AND gate will be here. AND gate both are 1, 1. So, 0, it is 0. 0, 0, it is 0. See, I'm ANDing these two, right? I'm ANDing these two. May they can call in. I'm ending these two first. Then 0 1 0 1 0 0. Then 1 1 1 1 is 1. That is okay. I agree with that. 1 1 is 1 because that is AND gate logic. 0 0 is 0. 0 1 is 0 1 0 is 0. So this is the number. Then you need to O that with the. Let's make it another color. Marking it in green. This one you have to O with this one. And then what is the answer? Answer will be 0 0 1. The 1 0 is 1. This is also 1. Then 0 0 1. This is also 1 0 0 1 1 0. That is it. Okay, then here ones are there, then here twos are not there, fours are not there, eights and 16. 16, 8, when you add, this is 16, this is 8. 16 plus 8 is 24, plus 1 is 25. Okay, I guess your answer is correct. So Kalhara has given answer 25, others has not given the answer. I think you all can understand this, right? If there are any difficulty, please let me know. Is there any ambiguous or difficult point to understand here, or all of you understood? Madhusha, did you understand? Madhushan. Terunal. Okay, Safiya, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Then that's it, and 25 will be the answer. You can test this. So always you are welcome to test. Let's use IDLE. And in IDLE, I'm going to test 17. O is there. O is pipe mark, right? O is pipe mark, that is under backspace. Shift and backslash. Shift and backslash will type this. This is the pipe mark. Then 9 and percent, and then what is 42? You can put space, that doesn't matter, right? You can put space, or you can write even without space. With space and without space, it will, doesn't matter, right? So you can say 25, and even without space also, that will be 25. So preference will be given to the end gate. That's it. Okay, now let's try to understand shifting. Now this is AND gate, OR gate. NOT gate also, I said NOT gate will simply reverse and generate the here. NOT gate will reverse and generate the 2's complement number. Here 9 is there. When 9 is there, when you reverse it, it will generate 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 0. So that is the reverse pattern. But the thing is, this reverse pattern will be understood as a 2's complement number. The reverse pattern will be understood as a 2's complement number. You know the nature of 2's complement. If number is a 2's complement, you have to invert that and add 1. When you invert that, so this is minus. Why? Because of the sign now. Sign has become minus. This is minus. When you invert, you will get, when you invert, you'll get 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, which is 9. But you have to add 1 to this. 9 plus 1 is 10. So the answer will be minus 10. So this is how the negative numbers are treated in when NOT gate is applied. So let me write down this, and you can write NOT 9 is equal to minus 10. And if it is not minus 10, not minus 10, it will be 9, the reverse, right? Not minus, because it will invert the negative number. Minus 10 is this, no? Negative number minus 10 is this, that will be inverted. When it is inverted, originally you will get the positive 9. This number is the negative number, no? Negative 10. This is negative 10. When it is inverted, you will get the positive 9. Right? When you invert this, you will get this pattern, but this will be understood as negative 10. That is because of the 2's complement patterns, which is used in negative number representation. We have learned that in 2's complement. I hope this is also clear. Let's move to the shifting now. Okay, now you know this part. What is this bitwise shifting? You have two things, right shift and left shift. Right shift, left shift. And here you can, this example, you can see this is right shifting. 10 is right shifted by 3 positions. 10 is 1010. When the first right shift done, this 0 will be hidden. It's like pushing. It's like pushing the number. Number ka tallu karna wage. It's like pushing the number, right side. And think that there is a cover. When you're pushing the number will be pushed, but there is a cover. This cover will generate the answer. The first push will keep 101. Then this is 10. 101 is 5. This is like dividing by 2, right? Here, 1010 is 10, but 101 is 5. Second push, it will be 10. 10 is 2. 5 divided by 2 is 2. Then the third shift, 2 divided by 2, it is 1. Again, shift 1 position, it's 1. It's like dividing by 2. So please write down this bitwise shifting. So please write down this. Okay, left shift is basically moving this left side. It is like multiplying by 2. Right shift, left shift. Right shift is basically dividing by 2. Left shift is multiplying by 2. What will happen? 12 is 1100. When you shift by 2, 1100, 11000. Another 0 is added. Another 0 is added. And what will happen? Always it will double. Because it move one position, means it will double. Here, 16 plus 8, 24. Here, 16 plus 32, 48. It always doubles. So that is the nature. Okay. So you can see the left shift, right shift example. So what will happen if you left shift and right shift 127? So I have done one part. So what is the final answer? Left shift 127 by 4 positions, same time right shift by 4 positions. So what will happen? So what is the answer? Left shift by 4 positions, right shift by 4 positions. Is it the same or is it different?
Different.
So what is the answer?
Answer has to be, so we have to multiply 7 by 2 4 times. So then I have to multiply 7 by 16.
7 by 2 4 times. Yeah, 7 by 16. No, you can just say 7 into 2 is 14. That into 2 is 28. That into 2 is 56. And that into 2 is 112. So final answer will be, so 127 was there, but the final answer will be 112. So please write down that as well, because right shifting and left shifting won't give the same answer if there are zeros, sorry, if there are ones at the end. That will, but if there are zeros at the end, maybe it can give the same answer. So for an example, if you try to do that for 112, right shifting by 4 times, that will remove 4 zeros. Left shifting by 4 times, that will give the same number. Right? If there are zeros, if right shifting is done for zeros, then bringing that back by left shifting is possible. But if right shifting is done for ones, bringing that back is impossible. So you will miss that part. Okay. So that is the idea of shifting. Okay, I think now you know operators very well. So let's do small thing. Okay, so I need another calculation. So let's give, can you give me the answer for these things? 198 shift by 3 position and give me an answer, then I'm going to say 23 by 2 positions. So can you tell me the answers quickly? It's easy calculation. So send answers within 1 minute, within 30 seconds, please. Within 30 seconds, please. So is 24, yeah, divide by 3 times 198 divide by 2 will be here 19 minute no attack. Sorry, name the heart 99. So divide by 2 again. 99 divided by 2 is 49, right? 49. That divide by 2 is 24. Yeah, correct. Right? 24, right? Switch with 24. So check again. Should be 24. Because first shift will divide 198, first shift 99. The second shift is 99 shifted by 1. So. And third shift will be 49 shifted by 1 position, that is 24. So if you do this one time, 24 is the answer. The other side, this is multiplying by 2 and again by 2. So 23 multiplied 46, then it is 92. Okay, 24, 2 is 96. 23. Okay, that's it. Easy. And another thing that we are going to learn, another thing here. I will give you a small exercise. This is just to understand some. Actually, this I have not discussed previously, but related to these operators again. But I have not discussed this previously. Therefore, I would like to discuss this now. If you get, if you write down this, this is for the characters. Let me start ideally again. This is there for the characters. But if you write down something like this, is the number. But if it is like this, it is a character, just string. And if it is a letter even, but these letters are also symbolized. We learned this in, actually, we learned this in right, if you are just trying to just remember, we have discussed number systems with the integer, with the character representation, ASCII, binary, different things. We have the ASCII representation, BCD representation, ABCD representation, Unicode representation. These are for character representations. So what is this character representation? Right, the character representation is this, basically. Okay, let's see. If it is letter A, there is a number for that. You can get this by this ORD command, ORD function. When you type character A, ORD will return the corresponding number related to that character. That is 65. And if you do the reverse, CHR, if you give a number, you will get a corresponding letter for that. Okay, you will get a corresponding letter for that. And I need you to do small thing. Okay, so this is to understand some other concept, which we will learn in networking. All encryption. Okay, so if you try to do something like this, still we have not discussed much about these loops and all, but I will teach you a small loop or small iteration, because when you learn the iteration, we have only learned about the sequence and these operators, and also we have discussed about the if-else statements, which is selection, right? Selection, if-else statement. But I have not discussed much about this repetition. So if you can remember, sequence is just writing instructions again and again. Selection is just if and else. If you can say, if, for an example, let's see, like CHR, if ORD, ORD, if ORD, let's say some character is greater than 45, okay, if ORD is greater than 45, do something. Print, let's say hello. This is a simple if without else. The hello will be printed if it is greater than 45. I'm rewriting this. If it is greater than 450, print error. But it is not greater than 450, therefore no hello is there. This is simple one condition, single condition. But if and else both are there, you need to write, maybe better write a new file. Better write new file if, let's say, okay, I'm going to get an input, A input, A equal input, enter a number. And after that, I'm going to check the number. If this A, I'm going to convert this to integer as well. Int will convert the number to integer, a number format. Otherwise, it will be text. If A, modulus, can you remember the modulus operator? What it does? Modulus operator. What it does? Yes. Matakanadda, can you remember modulus operator? What it does? Modulus demam mukadavin.
Actually, I can't remember though.
Modulus operator will divide and write the remainder. Divide and give the remainder, right?
Okay.
Okay. If it is equal to 1, I'm telling something. I'm telling print odd number. Else, if it is not, so it should be even, right? Else, print. This is how we can use the modulus operator to detect odd evenness of the number. Whether it's divisible by 2 and remaining is 1, then definitely it is odd number, otherwise it is even number. Let's run this code now. You are checking for a number, you can give one any number, and so it's odd or even. So it's checking the oddness and evenness of one. If it is a divisible number, it is odd. Sorry, it is even. If it is non-divisible, or if it remained is one non-divisible, then it is odd. So likewise, so this is how simple if else can be used. Hope you can remember that as well. And now I'm going to give you an idea about the repetition statement also. So here, let me add a repetition. So this can be added to text for, let's say, letter in message. You can give a message, some message like "Hello World." Okay, this simple thing will let you print letter by letter. So see how simple that is. So let me run the code and see, show you. Enter a number, okay. Odd number, and then it's printing "Hello World," because print, it prints downwards. "Hello World" prints downwards. Okay, if I want to print it horizontally, I can say letter N with maybe dash. Then if I run this, so letters will be printed, and after that a dash will be printed. "Hello World." But if you give a space, it will be printed with one space. "Hello World." Anyway, so my exercise or question is this. Use this. Use ORD and CHR functions and try to encrypt a message. What is encryption? Encryption means hiding the original message. Okay, let's see. The original message is "hello." In encryption, we will learn this in networking. Don't worry, still we have not discussed. Let's change letter by one position. H, next, what is the next letter? After H, what is the next letter? Oh, come on. They don't say that you don't know that letter. After H, what comes next? "Hello, I'm asking about the English alphabet."
I.
After E? After letter E?
F.
F. L?
M.
O?
E.
Okay, so in encryption is the concept where you have a readable plain text and it will be converted to unreadable ciphertext. So what is plain text? It is a readable text. And so the other one is unreadable text. So encryption is the process where you convert readable to unreadable. You convert plain text to ciphertext, or readable to unreadable. And in decryption, don't think that I'm teaching networking here, right? I want you to write an algorithm. In decryption, you get the ciphertext, that is IFMMP, that is called ciphertext, and that will be converted to readable plain text again. Okay, I have given few tips, right? I have given few tips. So you can, any character, it is possible to find out the character code by using ORD function. Any character number, you can convert back to a character by CHR function. Now, you know how to get letter by letter using this method. You can access letter by letter. I just need you to get letter by letter of a message and convert that message to a ciphertext. Let's give a try. A little difficult thing, but let's give a try. Otherwise, it is like your class will be boring otherwise. That's why I'm giving a challenging exercise. Let's try this. If you write like this, okay, letter, it will print the letter. But if I say ORD letter, what will happen? ORD letter, then what will happen? That will print the, very simple. So think in this way. So if I say ORD letter, then what will happen? Actually, this initial part not needed, right? This part we can just forget. This is anyway not related to this. So this is only 2-line code. So then what will happen? You will get the character number. Okay. So what happened if you just add one to this? Think. What happened if you add one to this? Here you got the number. Huh?
With the plus one.
Plus one will add one to this, right? Okay, think how simple this is. Okay, this is now add one, and you can see all the numbers are incremented by one. Okay, then after doing this, can't you convert that number to a CHR? Okay, still one line, still two lines, and you can see this. Hello, this message. So this is, initially message was hello world, but now you can see it's converted. And you can print both, right? You can print both means like you can first print the hello world, or you can get an input. Okay, let's say msg equal input, enter a message to encrypt. Okay. Enter a message to encrypt, and then you can iterate through that message . Okay, then you can give message here. Sorry. When you run, so it will ask for a message. Okay, enter a message to enter. Let's say I'm going to enter my name. When I type enter, you can see this is what I got. Okay, at least now you have to try the decryption message. So can you try the decryption algorithm? Do it alone. This is what the encryption is. I have done that. And no need to put space, right? Without space also you can give. And with no space, then you can see when I run this. So it will immediately print the message without any spaces. And so let's give the same name. I'm going to give the same name here. And you can see the message without any spaces. And this is what my name is. You can see my name. Even I cannot read my name. So this is what the encryption is. Now try for the decryption. Try to get a message like this and decrypt and display message. That is easy. Try. Finish? Yes or no? Huh? Copy and paste the same. Right? thinking is the only thing. Copy and paste the same and change this decrypt this time. Decrypt. Enter a message to decrypt. And this time, what you need to do, you have to subtract one from that. And it's very simple. It's very simple. And you'll get the original message back. And now it works encryption, decryption both. Let's try for the encryption. I'm trying to encrypt my name and I'm getting the result here. A message to decrypt, and then I have to put this. This need to be in the next line, right? Anyway. Okay, you can see it's I'm getting back the message here. I need empty print to separate the encryption message with the decryption message. Otherwise, it will not go to the next line. Let's add few empty lines. Or you can just add empty line by printing a new line character like this. That will add a new line. Run it. Okay, now we can see I'm going to copy and paste my name there. Okay, it says enter the message to decrypt. I'm going to retype, copy and paste this again, and can see it gives me my name back. That's it. These are using the character codes.
Finished it.
Okay. Right, let's stop with that for today. Next day I'll be discussing. Now this you have to try, right? Try it alone and do it and experiment only. No need to try this. No need to learn the encryption decryption here. But the thing is that whatever we are learning in Python can be applied in various applications. That's what you need to learn. Simple, right? Encryption and decryption are just two things. And so you can try a lot of things using probe. When you learn a programming language today, you can do magics. You can do magic, security related thing, hacking related thing. So you can do a lot. Right? When we learn the file reading and writing, you can see how web scraping can be done. Web scraping is like one of the most interesting area in ethical hacking. And also in security as well as, so you can obtain data from a website and organize that data according to the way you like. So with the programming, we can do a lot. So let's do more experiment. Each day I will teach you new things for the practical applicability. In the examination, I don't think that they will ask these things, but even though they ask, that doesn't matter. You can write the answer easy. Okay, then good night. See you all next week.